Captured in 1826, 200 years ago, this is the first photograph in the world. Captured with the humble camera obscura. For context, television came 150 years later. So how did these ancient cameras work? Imagine a darkened room, sunlight streaming through a tiny hole in one wall. On the opposite wall, an inverted image of the outside world appears. This early device laid the groundwork for modern photography. Fast forward to 1839, Louis Daguerre, a Frenchman with a penchant for capturing light, unveiled the daguerreotype. It was the first publicly announced photographic process. The process used a polished silver plate, sanitized with iodine vapor, exposed to light, and then developed with mercury fumes. The 20th century dawned and photography exploded. The megascope, a camera that could capture sweeping panoramas, allowed us to see the world in widescreen. But it was the Kodak Brownie that made photography accessible. Introduced in 1900, it was affordable, portable, and easy to use. Suddenly, everyone could be a documentarian of their lives. This is how the snapshot was born. Then came the Leica, a sleek German marvel. It used 35mm film, a format still beloved by enthusiasts today. Compact and precise, the Leica made photography nimble, an invention that truly let people capture life as it happened. Then in 1947, the Duoflex came along. It was a compact single-lens SLR camera with an eye-level viewfinder. Suddenly, composing shots became an art form. Meanwhile, the Polaroid Model 95 spat out instant photos, eliminating the waiting time at a photo developer. The late 20th century saw seismic shift in the technology. In 1975, Kodak came up with the digital camera, a clunky beast that recorded black and white image on cassette tapes. Then came the quick snap. Fuji's disposable marvel. These cameras came with inbuilt film. Finally, when the Kodak DCS SLR hit the markets in 2000, it marked the professional leap into digital. Suddenly, pixels danced across screens, and memory cards replaced film canister. Cameras slimmed down, megapixels multiplied, and we all became accidental photographers. It was this camera that opened the world to content creation. Now cameras are smarter with touchscreen and Wi-Fi. Today our phones produce better photographs than most professional cameras. Imagine telling this to the guy who spent a week developing world's first photo.